warm, beautiful, and again rainy southeast Queensland in Australia. I'm sitting here in my caravan and doing some custom orders. Yesterday, I came across a post in one of our local Facebook groups from the area where we are staying at the moment. And the lady was looking for an embroidery service to put some names on her horse rugs. So I responded to this post and I got the job. And while I was doing the order today, I thought it is a good opportunity to actually record this making and give you some tips and hints on embroidering on horse rugs. The most important thing is that you have to remember you can't actually hoop such items because they are too thick for your embroidery hoop. You will have to float them, and that means that you have to secure those items with a basting stitch. And if your design doesn't come with a basting stitch, then you can just use the feature on your embroidery machine to add a basting stitch and create the name that you want to embroider. For example, in this video, I digitized the name in my embroidery software, but you can also do that on your embroidery machine. Just use some bold, large fonts and use the basting stitch to secure the rug on the stabilizer before you actually stitch the design. Hoop these items. I just float them. I use two layers of tearaway stabilizer. Additionally, I use is double-sided adhesive water-soluble quilter's tape, which I place just outside these basting stitch. And then once I've done the embroidery, I just remove this stuff, and that is what it looks like. It's from So Easy, and I use this stuff all the time, even for all my in the hoop projects to secure zippers and stuff like that. So, but in this case, it came in handy to secure the rug on the stabilizer. And as you have seen before, I also used some pins to hold the fabric in place, especially here with these rugs. They have the lining on the back, so you have to make sure that you don't have any wrinkles when you place that stuff on the hoop, and everything will turn out perfectly and fine and flat. There you go. Easy to do. You just have to undo the basting stitch now, remove the water-soluble topping, which I used here, to ensure that the embroidery doesn't sink into the fleece itself, so it's easily nice to read. These jobs are a 5 to 10 minute jobs, depends on your experience. And yeah, personalized horse rugs. So here are now the two finished rugs I just did for a customer. The back is actually done with white bobbin thread, and there is a reason for that. You may wonder why I use the white and not matching with the black lining. But first of all, it's not visible anyway when the horse is wearing the rug. And second,
if the handler is putting the rug onto the horse, or like the handlers have, for example, trainers have different horses, different rugs, rah, rah, and they're just grabbing the rug and seeing the inside, even the name is mirrored, they can actually read the name and know exactly on which rug goes on which horse. So very easy to do. Nice solution. And Rosie is now ready to go to the trainer. Happy days, happy customer.